Hi, my name is Fred Kohler, and I'm a member of the Solidworks training team. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a copied sketch that can be changed, and a derived sketch that can't. Using derive or copy generally also requires the editing tool Modify Sketch. Let's get started. Using copy sketch can be as simple as selecting the sketch, copying, and pasting. The sketch can be pasted on any planar face or plane within the part, or even in a different part. The copied sketch is just that, a true copy, and it can be changed independently of the original sketch. Here I'll expand Boss Extrude 5, select Sketch 2, and click Edit Copy. I'll roll back before the holes, select a face, and click Edit Paste. Here's where the Modify Sketch tool comes in. It can be used to scale, translate, or rotate an underdefined sketch. After editing the sketch, I'll click Tools, Sketch Tools, Modify Sketch. We want to rotate the sketch, so in Rotate, I'll type 180 degrees, press Enter, and click Close. Now we can make any changes we want. I'll add relations to tie it to the existing geometry and dimensions to fully define it. To finish up this model, we can extrude the sketch, add a hole, and fillets. I want to copy that same sketch into another part, so I'll select Sketch 2 again and press Ctrl-C. We can select the top plane and paste the sketch using Ctrl-V. I'll edit the sketch and tie it to the geometry. Derived sketches require selecting both an existing sketch and a plane or planar face. I'll select Sketch 2 and the right plane, then click Insert Derived Sketch. The sketch is reversed, so this time I'll start Modify Sketch by searching commands with the text Modify. This time we'll mirror the sketch. I'll position the cursor over one of the points on the axis and right-click to mirror the sketch. Using the left mouse button, I'll drag the sketch to the other side of the model and click Close. To fully define the sketch, I'll add some relations. The new sketch has Derived appended to the name. After adding some geometry, I'll double-click Boss Extrude 2 and make changes to the dimensions through the source sketch. The source sketch drives changes in the derived sketch. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access more great content.